Hello guys, I hope you all are doing good. I am Vishali Kikan and we are discussing the VLSI technology. In that, we are discussing the metallization, and this is the last video associated with the metallization. And after this video, I hope most of your topics in the metallization will be covered. If I forget any topic, you can tell me that topic and I will try to cover that topic as well. So, as I promised you, today in this video, we are going to talk about the copper metallization, which is very important part for your R&D purposes as well as for the future researches as well and for future fabrication, for future understanding. This topic is very important. I hope you all are watching this video with utmost attention. So coming to the copper, why I'm moving towards the copper? There must be some advantages associated with the copper. First of all, it is a better conductor than the aluminium. This is a very big advantage associated with the copper. It is giving me higher speed with the lesser power consumption. The second big advantage of using copper, it is having the lesser electromigration problem, or it is having a higher electromigration resistance, the next advantage. But there are some disadvantages as well. That is, it is going to diffuse freely in silicon and the silicon dioxide, which is causing the metal contamination. Okay, so we have to use the barrier layer. We can use the barrier layer of tantalum or tantalum nitride. So the second disadvantage is that it is hard to dry etch. There is no simple gaseous chemical compound which can be used for the formation of the deposition of the copper. So we can use Damascene's process with the CMP. We are going to go in detail about the chemical metallical polishing CMP process in detail in some upcoming videos, so that you will be clear about these process. Okay, so I'm going to show you with the pictures also what is the CMP process doing. We can use the tantalum or the tantalium nitride as the barrier layer. Okay, or we can use both of them as the barrier layer. This process has started using the IC fabrication, so copper has penetrated in the IC fabrication. So first of all, we are going to do the pre-deposition clean, then we are going to do the PVD of the barrier layer. Okay, so the deposition of the barrier layer, what is the barrier layer formed of? It is formed of the tantalum and the tantalum nitride, or both of them. So after that, we are going to do the PVD of the copper seed layer. And after that, we are going to do the electrochemical plating of the bulk copper layer. So first of all, the barrier layer, then the copper seed layer, and then the electrochemical plating. Electrochemical plating is a very simple process. We have all talked about it in the 11th or the 12th class. It's a very simple process. So this deposition of the copper is consisting of only 4 steps, which is very less as compared to the previous processes of aluminium or the tungsten that we have already talked about. So this is why the copper is of utmost interest in the metallization. Okay, I hope now you understood the importance of the copper. After that, it is done the thermal annealing. Okay, the thermal annealing is done to improve the conductivity. So conductivity is further increased. So first of all, I'm going to etch the trenches and the wire holes. Okay, so you can see we have used the silicon nitride layer. This is the copper for the wire holes. Okay, after that we have the tantalum barrier layer and the copper seed layer deposition. So this is the tantalum or the tantalum nitride barrier layer formed. Okay, so this is the uppermost blue layer, that is tantalum or the tantalium nitride barrier layer. After that we have the seed deposition of the copper. Okay, so after that we can do the electrochemical plating. So when we do the electrochemical plating, we have the deposition of the copper. This is how in full of the area the copper will be deposited. After that we are going to do the chemical metallical polishing of the copper and the tantalum, and after that we are going to deposit the nitride. Okay, so this is how after that we are going to deposit the silicon nitride layer. So what are all of the processes associated with it? First of all, we have the pre-clean process. So in the pre-clean, we are using the argon sputtering pre-deposition clean. Okay, so it is the most commonly used process where we are using the argons. So Now, what can happen? The copper contamination can happen due to the sputtering. So, to avoid that, we are using the pre-clean process. We can use the chemical pre-clean or the argon sputtering pre-deposition clean. Argon sputtering pre-deposition clean is not using any chemical reactions, but we can use some chemical reactions also, like we can use the hydrogen and the helium plasma, and where the hydrogen radicals can react with CuO2 and it can form the copper and the water vapor. Coming to the barrier layer, after that we are going to form the barrier layer. Copper diffuses into the silicon and cause the device damaging. I have told you how we can have the heavy metal contamination with the help of copper. So we need a barrier layer. Barrier layer is an utmost important thing that we need. So we can use the barrier layer, we can form the barrier layer with the titanium, titanium nitride, tellurium, tellurium nitride, and tungsten, tungsten nitride. So we can use any one of them, we can form the barrier layer. The barrier layer would be a few hundred angstrom, and the tantalum is the most commonly used metal. So this is tantalum and this is the tantalum nitride. So these are two most commonly used metals which are used for the barrier layer formation. We can use the combination of both of them as well. Coming to the copper seed layer, copper seed layer is a thin layer which is of 500 to 2000 angstrom thickness. It forms the nucleation site for the bulk copper grain and film formation. If I am not forming the seed layer, this is a very big doubt in all of your minds, that why I am forming the seed layer. Without the seed layer, there will be no deposition, or the deposition would be of very poor quality, or the uniformity would not be there. To get a good quality deposition, to get a better uniformity, I must have a better seed layer. So seed layer is a very important part of the copper deposition. So we have the copper vapors which can be easily ionized at the low pressure, and we are getting the longer mean free path at the low pressure, because at the low pressure we have less of the atoms in the surrounding. When we have less atoms in the surrounding, one atom can go to a longer distance without getting collided with the another atoms, and this is how I am getting a longer mean free path if I am having the low pressure. Copper ions throw into the via and the trench, and this is how I am getting a good step coverage. So copper is directly going and it is filling the via trench. It is not getting deviated with the smaller mean free path, because it is having low pressure condition. Mean free path would be high. Copper atoms are going reaching to the via holes position. So it is going to give me good step coverage and smoother film surface. So we will be getting very narrow via holes. PVD of copper will be done in trouble due to its poor step coverage. CVD of the copper process will be needed. So whenever I am using copper, I will be looking towards the CVD. We can use the electrochemical plating, which is an older technology. I have told you it's the same technology that we have talked about in the 11th or the 12th class in chemistry. This is the same process which is still used in the hardware, glass, in the auto and the electronics industry. It is recently introduced in the IC industry for the bulk copper deposition at the low temperature. So it is also a low temperature process. It is compatible with the low dielectric polymeric dielectric compounds. So what we are doing in the electrochemical plating, we are using the copper sulfate solution. We are using copper at the anode. We are putting the wafer with the copper seed layer at the cathode. So now we have the wafer with the copper seed layer on it. We are putting it at the cathode. So when we are going to supply the electric current, the copper ions diffuse and deposit on the wafer. So you can see here at the anode we have the copper. This is the solution, blue solution of the CuSO4. And this is the wafer holder which is made of plastic, which is rotating. And this is where we have the wafer. And wafer is attached here. And this is how the copper ions are moving and getting deposited here with the help of electrochemical plating. So our wafer is placed at the cathode. So now coming to the via and trench hill. To achieve the better gap fill, pulse current with large forward amperage and small reverse amperage is used. So whenever I want to put the copper ion in a particular direction only, so I will be giving a full forward current and less backward or reverse current, so that the copper ions will be moving more in the particular forward direction only. Reverse current removes the copper. which reduces the overhang of the gap, so we require lesser and lesser of reversed current. It is a similar process to the deposition etch as well as deposition process. So now we can use the additives also to reduce the deposition on the corner to improve the via fill capability. So we can use some additives also here in this process. You can see we have the tantalum barrier layer. After that we have the copper seed layer, and we can use this electrochemical plating via fill for the deposition of the copper in this via hole as well. So coming to the CVD. So this was all about the electrochemical plating. Coming to the CVD, in the CVD we must be using some chemical reactions. We can use the bishexafluoroacetylacetonate copper or CuHfAc2. CuHfAc2 is going to react with the hydrogen to form the copper as well as 2HfAc. Okay, so this is a reaction which is taking at 350 to 450 degrees Celsius, which is too high for a polymeric low dielectric constant material. This is the formula for the CuHfAc2. Okay, so you can remember this formula. It's a simple formula that can be remembered easily. So coming to the CVD of the copper. CVD of the copper can be done with the help of organometallic compound CuHfAc-TmVS, which is having the formula C10H13CuF6O2Si. So you can remember the compound formula C10H13CuF6O2Si, or you can simply remember it as CuHfAc-TmVS. So it is going to dissociate at a high temperature like 175 degrees Celsius to form copper and CuHfAc2 and 2TmVS. So the pressure is 1 to 3 torr. So it is going to give me excellent step coverage and also the gap fill capability. So whenever I am using CuHfAc-VTMS, it is giving me more promising output. It is giving me more promising copper CVD deposition. So CVD is done, which is a better process. It is going to give me tough competition from the production proven copper electrochemical process. So we are confused in both of them. You can see which process is better in which scenario, which process is having good advantages and disadvantages also. So PVD and CVD of copper seed layer deposition, you can compare. So in the summary, we have talked about the main application of the metallization, that is interconnection. After that, we have talked about the CVD as well as PVD. CVD is mostly preferred for the tungsten, titanium nitride and the titanium. PVD is done for the aluminium copper alloy deposition, titanium and the titanium nitride. Aluminium copper alloy is still dominant, okay, because of the high conductivity associated with it. But we need ultra high vacuum condition for the aluminium copper PVD. We can use tungsten as a plug, okay. Titanium is used as a welding layer. Titanium nitride is a barrier addition and the ARC layer. The future is copper and the tantalum and the tantalum nitride. So these are the references, really amazing book. You can refer these books for all of the topics which I might have left, or you can suggest me those topic. I will be trying to make the videos on those topic as well. If you have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment, and I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also do share it with your friends. Thank you so much.